You can read this for yourself in 2 Chronicles chapter 20. I'm not giving you the whole story. I'm not reading the whole story for you tonight. You can read it on your own time. But God says, send the singers out first, and they're to sing a little chorus. God's love lasts forever. Basically, the loving kindness of the Lord endures forever. That's basically a little chorus they were to sing. They were to go before the army and sing this little chorus. And God said, you're not going to have to fight this battle. The singers will bring the victory for you. Okay. Now notice what happened here. As they began, as this group, they're going out first, as they began to sing and praise, sing and what?
Praise.
Sing and?
Praise.
Judah, let God be praised. As they began to sing and praise, what did the Lord do? The Lord set ambushes against the men of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir who were invading Judah, and they were defeated. Notice how they were defeated. The Ammonites and the Moabites, that were two of the enemy groups, rose up against the men from Mount Seir to destroy and annihilate them. After they finished slaughtering the men from Mount Seir, they helped to destroy one another. In essence, the enemy destroyed himself. Okay. Why? Because they offered praise to God. And so you have to understand that God has given you a weapon to use, a key to use when you're under attack, and that key to use is the key of worship. It is a powerful key. It is the key of praise, but it will not work unless you use it, unless I use it. Whether another example of this, Ephesians chapter 5. We're just about done here tonight. Do not get drunk on wine. That's another whole message for me to preach sometime. Okay. Which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit. Now, would you agree with me if you're filled with the Spirit, you're a lot stronger in battle, correct? Okay. If you're in the flesh, you're not going to have the strength necessary, but to be filled with the Spirit. Now, how do we get filled with the Spirit? How do we set ourselves up for the Spirit to be at work in us? Speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit. Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let me tell you why praise is important. Because when you praise, you're creating an atmosphere for the Holy Spirit to come into you and upon you and around you. You create an atmosphere for the presence of God. And the reason that many of us are, if you will, missing an atmosphere of God's presence in our lives, in our homes, in our families, is because we don't spend any time creating that atmosphere by praise. I think it's time to change that. How about you? So we praise and we invite the Spirit that gives us the ability to war against those things of darkness that come our way.